Hi everyone, in this video we'll go through one marker questions from integral calculus. First question, find the integral of secant square x minus 5. So what is integral of secant square? Integral of secant square is tan. So instead of x we put x minus 5 as is. That's all. Remember one thing. So you should always put the coefficient of x in the denominator. Here there is nothing, that there is only one here. So we can ignore. But if it was something like this, if it was like this, right, then we would be writing this as tan of 3x minus 5 by coefficient of x. What is coefficient of x? What is the number next to x? 3. So I'll put 3 in the denominator, right? This is the difference between these two problems. Next one, evaluate this integral function. So here there are two ways to do this. You can refer my integral calculus videos, right? Lot of such examples are explained. There are two methods to solve these problems using method of substitution, right? So one way is directly you can imagine or visualize this as x, right? So what is integral of x square? What is the integral formula? Integral of x to the power n is x to the power n plus 1 by n plus 1. This is the formula for integral of x to the power n. So what I do, you can assume this entire thing is x and you have power as 2. So what I will do, I can write 2x plus 3 as is, increment the power. It's 2 here, so this will become 2 plus 1, which is 3. And the denominator I'll put the incremented power, that is I'll put 3 here, right? And then you should not forget the coefficient of x. What is coefficient of x? It's 2. So 3 into 2 becomes 6, right? This is the answer. So very quickly you'll get this answer if you do this. Or you can use a substitution method. You can assume that this is t, right? T is equal to this. Differentiate this. So I'll get dt by dx. Dt by dx is, what is derivative of 2x? 2. What is derivative of 3? 0. So here dt by dx is 2. Therefore, what is dt? Dt is 2 dx. And what is dx? Dx is half dt, right? I shift 2 here. So it'll become half dt. That's dx. So instead of dx here, I put half dt. Instead of dx, I put half dt. And this is t and I have to put the power t square. Now, what is integral of t square? I have to apply this formula, right? This formula I have to apply. So, increment the power. So, it will become 2 plus 1 and put that power in the denominator. So, it will be t cube by 3, right? And this half, I'm just copying half here. Right, and then last step, instead of t, I'll substitute the original function, which is 2x plus 3. 2x plus 3 to the power 3 by 6. So both the methods will give the same answer. Depends on which you are comfortable with. Next problem, evaluate this particular integral. These problems are very simple. You'll have to remember that integral of 1 by x is log x. Right, like derivative of log x is 1 by x. So, integral of 1 by x is log x, just the reverse, right? If you forget the integral, remember the derivative. So, if you know the derivative, you can find the integral. If you know the integral, you can get the derivative. So assume that this is x, 1 by x. What is integral of 1 by x? Log x. So, I'll simply put log x here. But instead of x, what do I have? I have 7x plus 8. So, copy 7x plus 8. Then, we should not forget the coefficient. What is coefficient of x? 7. And this 7 should come in the denominator. And we need to put plus c. Again, you can use a substitution method also. You can assume that 7x plus 8 is t. And then differentiate it. Find what dx is. We have to always find dx because you have dx here. So you have to substitute here dt by 7. Then instead of 7x plus 8, I put t. And integral of 1 by t is log t. And this 1 by 7. Then I substitute t. What is t? 7x plus 8. So both the methods, same answer. Now another example, evaluate integral of 1 by 4x plus 3. Here it was 7x plus 8. Here it is 4x plus 3. Same problem. You can directly take, you know, 1 by, assume that this is x. 1 by x is log x. So instead of x, we have 4x plus 3. And what is the coefficient of x here? 4. Put it in the denominator. That's all. And plus c. So these kind of problems are very simple. Now, here's another problem. 7 to the power 3x plus 4. You have to remember this one. like the way we remembered in differential calculus, right? Derivative of a to the power x is a to the power x into log a. Similarly, integral of a to the power x is a to the power x by log a, right? Remember this. Derivative of a to the power x is a to the power x into log a. Integral of a to the power x is a to the power x divided by log a. So that's what we have put here. Instead of a, we have 7. And instead of x, we have 3x plus 4. So we will put this entire function, right? Like this, a to the power x is 7. Instead of x, we have 3x plus 4. And then a is 7 here. So log 7. And we should not forget the coefficient of x. What is coefficient of x? 3. Put it in the denominator. And then plus c. Here, next problem. Integral of this, straightforward. Find integral of this separately and integral of separately. Whenever you have addition or subtraction of terms, it's straightforward. Just find integral separately. Now, keep 7 as is. Integral of x square is x cube by 3. That is, you have to increment the power and put that power in the denominator. Similarly here, keep this 4 as is. Integral of secant square is tan x. That's all. Yet another example. Find the value of 8 by cosec x. Now, what is cosec x? 1 by sin x is cosec x, right? Here I have 1 by cosec x. So what is 1 by cosec x? 1 by cosec x is sin x, right? 1 by cosec x becomes sin x. So I put sin x here, 8 sin x, simple. What is integral of sin x? It's minus cos x. So minus 8 cos x. Keep the constant as is, right? Keep the constant as is, plus c. Next one, very simple. What is integral of 3 by x? Keep 3 outside. So what we are left with? 1 by x. What is integral of 1 by x? Log x. And then plus c. Similarly here, 5 by x, same thing. So put 5 outside. Integral of 1 by x is log x plus c. Next one, evaluate secant square x minus 5. What is integral of secant square? Tan. Instead of x, we have x minus 5. Right? If you had 2x minus 5, then it would have been divided by 2. You're copying the coefficient of x in the denominator. Next one, evaluate 1 by 5 into e to the power minus x. So you have negative power here. So we can take it to the top, right? It will become e to the power minus x will become e to the power x when you take it to the numerator. What is integral of e to the power x? E to the power x itself. And then put this 1 by 5 as is plus c. Next one, again straightforward. Find integrals separately. Because you have plus and minus here. So integral of x to the power e. This is of the form x to the power n. What is integral of x to the power n? X to the power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Instead of n, we have e here. So it will be x to the power e plus 1 by e plus 1. Right? Then integral of e to the power x is e to the power x itself. Log a is a number. So integral of log a would be log a is a number. So just copy log a as is. There is nothing here. That means you assume that there is 1. Assume that there is 1 here. Log a into 1. And integral of 1 is x. Always remember this. Integral of 1 is x. And then put plus c here. Next one. We will evaluate this particular expression. Very simple. What is integral of e to the power x? It is e to the power x itself. So just that you have minus here. So you put minus in the denominator, minus 1, right? You have to always put the coefficient of x in the denominator. Your coefficient of x is minus 1, right? So I put minus 1. So it will be minus e to the power minus x plus c. Next problem, straightforward. Find integral separately. Integral of x square is, take x, increment the power 2 plus 1, which is 3. Copy that power to the denominator. Then here, integral of 1 by x is, keep 6 outside. Integral of 1 by x is log x. Keep 5 outside. Integral of e to the power x is e to the power x itself plus c. Now this one, straightforward. Keep 4 outside. Keep the number outside. Integral of secant square is tan x. Right? And plus c. It should be plus c here. And plus c. Next one, the value of integral of 2 by e to the power x. So what I will do is, I'll take this e to the power x on top, right? So it will become e to the power minus x. Why I'm doing that? Because I know integral of e to the power x as e to the power x itself. So what I'll do, I'll take this e to the power x on top, it will become minus x. So integral of e to the power x is e to the power x itself. Similarly, e to the power minus x is also e to the power minus x, but in the denominator, I'll get minus 1 like this, because I'll have to put coefficient of x in the denominator. Coefficient of x is minus, that is minus 1. Right? So this is the answer. Now find the value of this particular expression. So keep 2 outside. So I'm left with 1 by 1 plus x. So you can assume this entire thing is x, right? So it's like 1 by x, right? What is integral of 1 by x? What is integral of 1 by x? It's log x. So, but instead of x, what do I have? 1 plus x. So, log 1 plus x, and I have 2 here. And I have to put plus c. This is the answer. Next one. This is definite integral problem. We'll just solve 2-3 problems of definite integrals. So if you have something like this, integral of x square and the limits are 0 and 1. What is integral of x square? X cube by 3, right? Increment the power and put that in the denominator. X cube by 3. Now you take the lower limit, upper limit, right? Substitute. So instead of x, I put 1, 1 by 3. And instead of x, I put 0. So 0 by 3. Subtract, I'll get the answer. This is another example. What is integral of x? Assume that there is nothing here, right? So assume it's 1. So I increment the power. So it'll become 2 when I increment this power. Then put that 2 in the denominator. Now I apply the limits. Instead of x, I put 2, 2 square, right? And then instead of x, I put 1, 1 square, right? I simplify and I get this as answer. Now, last problem, integral of tan square x dx, right? Here, we don't know the integral of tan square, right? So what I will do is, I'll substitute, I'll use one of the trigonometric formulas, which is 1 plus tan square x is secant square x. 1 plus tan square x is secant square x. I know the integral of secant square x. Integral of secant square is tan x. Right? So what I will do, I'll use this particular formula. So instead of tan square x, I'll write this as, instead of tan square x, I'll write it as secant square x minus 1. This is tan square x. So now I'll find the integral of this separately and this separately. Integral of secant square x is tan x, and integral of 1 is x plus c. So with this, we've come to the end of this particular topic. If you found this video useful, do press a like and share it. Thank you.